Oh, for simpler designs, the auto-router can save you time and headache, but be careful, it can also mess your PCB. Not only is it inefficient, but also it can flat out short your traces. I have seen it happen. You don't have to do everything manually at the beginning, but at least learn to trace the important components first and let the auto-router do the rest. You can usually start by creating a top and bottom ground planes, then trace the critical components first, like communication buses and capacitors. One of the first mistakes I made was adding a copper area right under the antenna of the ESP8266 microcontroller. This almost killed the Wi-Fi range. It is always a good idea to check the hardware design guidelines from the manufacturer. For example, here is the one for the ESP8266. Note the clearance and the orientation recommendations here. You can always start from here and improve it. Not once I have regretted adding extra test points or connections on my PCB. If you have the chance to break out any pin you think you might use, do it. Even for the extra pins that you don't think you're gonna need. This could save your design, money and time. It also has the added bonus of reusing the same PCB for other projects due to its flexibility. And it doesn't cost anything extra. Components come in many formats and sizes. Before picking a layout or a size, do yourself a favor and search their availability and prices out there. It also can help with confirming the pins in the datasheet. Packages from different manufacturers might have different pin numbers, so pay attention to that. And just because something is on DigiKey or Mouser today, doesn't mean it will be there when you are ready, so plan ahead. And now today's video sponsor, PCBWay. I have been using PCBWay for years, and they are my go-to manufacturer for all my prototypes. I've been averaging a week from the time I place an order to the time I have them in my hands. I'm very happy with the quality so far, and ordering PCBs have come a long way, especially for hobbyists. So I encourage you to give them a visit. I will put a link to their site down below. When we are submerged in a design, we start having blind spots and we sometimes overlook important things. In one of my earlier designs, I added an ESP01 as an alternative to the ESP12 last minute, not realizing that by adding a coin battery, I basically created a short in my sensor. Another example is when I wanted to make a cutout for an 18650 battery, I forgot to make the PCB thicker and ended up with an easily breakable PCB. So make sure you check, double check, review your work, sleep on it, or even better, get an extra set of eyes to review it for you. Do you know what is worse than making a mistake? Keep making the same mistake over and over. I recommend you keep a checklist and review it before submitting your PCB order. You can use it to prevent previous mistakes from happening again. New mistakes in general are not always bad, so don't be afraid to make them. And remember, mistake is just another word for experience. So good luck with your PCB designs, and thank you for watching.